Again, submerging coastlines do not exclusively have depositional or aggradational landforms. They may very well have erosional landforms or degradational landforms, but submerging coastlines are dominated by depositional landforms. These are the ones I want you to know. Really? It's a bunch of sand. Of course, a beach. I mean, I don't even know how to define the thing to tell you the truth. A spit is a beach that stretches partway across a bay. A bay mouth bar is a beach that completely encloses a bay. So if a beach is stretching part of the way across a bay, it's a spit. If it completely encloses the bay, it's a bay mouth bar, like Bolsa Chica Beach in Southern California. And a tombolo, this is a name that I use if I want to check into some place and I don't want people to know that I'm famous. So I'll check in rather than as Bill Porter, I check in as Tom Bolo. A tombolo is a beach that connects a sea stack to the shoreline. All right, left-hand side, you've seen that before, that's a beach. Now, if you look at the right-hand side, that white arrow is pointing at a spit. Can you see what happens here? The wave action forces this sand out here, creating this spit, this kind of hook that hangs off there. And if you look carefully, you can see down here on the bottom of this photograph the way the beach is being stretched out. This is indicating that the current is coming in this direction, and the waves are tending to break in this direction, which is pulling the sand out into that bay of water. These are also spits. You can see there's a spit going along here. Notice that this area right here behind the spit, the waves come in, crash along the beach. But this area, because it's now protected by the spit of sand, is beginning to fill in. Vegetation, materials of earth type, like sand and rocks and gravel and alluvium, are all going to be deposited there, which slowly fills that area in. You can see the same thing over here with this spit. And in fact, there's houses that are built here because the beach itself is protecting this area from the waves. And as a result of that, vegetation can grow there and the area can sort of develop into either urban development or you can leave it as wetlands or whatever it's going to be. This is a bay mouth bar. You can see that bay mouth bar. See the way the bays are back here and the beach stretches along there, completely enclosing this back bay area. Typically, as this fills in, like we just saw a second ago with the spits, the type of vegetation that grows in that type of area tends to be halophytic vegetation. Halophytic vegetation, like this mangrove swamp. Halophytic vegetation means that the vegetation is salt tolerant. This comes from halite, which is salt. And hydrophytic vegetation. Hydrophytic vegetation is vegetation that lives in water. So all vegetation, or most of it, is going to need water. But this literally is living in water. Like, for example, seaweed or kelp is both hydrophytic and halophytic, but I'm talking about vegetation that's on land. Then you can see that black arrow is pointing at a tombolo. The tombolo is the beach that's connecting this sea stack, Morro Rock right there. It's connecting it to the shoreline. Otherwise, this would be an exclusive island out here. But this beach stretches out and connects Morro Rock, which is a sea stack, to the shoreline. The beach is the tombolo.